Welcome to Link G4x Training Part 33. In this video, we're going to be taking a look at working with our closed loop boost control. Our closed loop control is going to allow us to have a target boost that we set and program within our software. We have our base wastegate duty cycle table that's going to allow us to get the duty cycle to send out to the boost solenoid pretty close, so the control's right around the target boost that we're requesting. Now we're going to be integrating proportional, integral, and derivative type control into our boost routine so that we can allow the link to take action, start with the duty cycle values from our base table, and manipulate them to hit the target that we're after. There's going to be a process or an order of operations that we need to work through here in order to make our boost control function properly. Then on top of this, we're going to have a variety of different boost control strategies we have to program for the target boost levels that we're going to be working with. I'm going to show you a whole bunch of details in order to set up and work with closed loop control. So let's jump into this video so we can get started. Okay, so let's get started. We're going to be taking a look at working with our closed loop style boost control within our PCLink software. In our last video, we explored our open loop style boost control. The open loop's where we just program a certain amount of duty cycle. We're going to be sending it to the boost control solenoid that's going to allow us to turn up the boost past our wastegate spring level. There's going to be no targeting. There's going to be no feedback or control right from the link directly. And we're finding closed loop control. This complicates things a little bit further. We're going to be giving a target for the link to try to reach. It's going to be working in a proportional, integral, and derivative style control. So it's going to always make adjustments to the base wastegate duty cycle table values that we program and trying to vary the duty cycle so we hit the boost that we're requesting within our programming, in our tables that we're working with. So the closed loop control does complicate things a little bit, but we'll find that what we've learned in the open loop video will apply here, and we're going to be able to build on all of that information. Now, I am going to be treating these videos as two separate videos. We're going to go over a lot of what we've covered in that open loop video here in the beginning of this video, in case you're skipping over the open loop control video and you're going right into the closed loop control, or in the future, if you want to go and jump into this closed loop style video and you want to focus on key topics in here, everything will be contained into one video, a little bit easier to search in the course library. So what I'm going to do is actually jump from our basics page, and we're going to use our little green toggle arrow here and toggle over on the top of our screen here into our page labeled CLBST, or for closed loop boost. We do have our OLBST. That's what we looked at in the last video for open loop style boost control, but now we're going to be working in this closed loop control. So let's click on this page. We're going to find we have a lot of things on screen. We have a ton of live digital gauges here at the top that can tell us all kinds of things that are going on with our routine. We're going to find we have a ton of different tables here to work with and to program. So there's a lot of flexibility in our closed loop boost control. I'm going to try to cover as much as I can here in all the different kind of strategies we have to work with so you can implement them in your calibration process. If we actually look to the bottom of the screen, we're going to find our bar here. We can actually use this to go over towards the right side of our page layout. This page layout is relatively large, but it has to be because we have a lot of things and a lot of tables to access and to be able to work with. We'll find on the right side of our page, we have our time plot. So all these channels here relate specifically to our closed loop style control. So if we're taking a look at this, we have our engine speed, we have our throttle position, we have our map pressure and the boost target, we have our actual wastegate duty cycle, what's going to be sent to the boost control solenoid, we have our proportional, integral, and derivative terms in control in this closed loop format. So this is all the most important channels to take a look at in working with our data logging and the boost control. And then we have our parameters list here. I have a bunch of different parameters list that are going to be relating to working with our control here and doing our calibration process. So everything is going to be set up here on screen that you can just immediately start to work with this and be able to be successful in programming in the closed loop style format. Now, before we go into taking a look at any of the details here for programming, I want to talk about the basics with our boost control and the turbocharger and the wastegates, just so you understand what we're working with here mechanically, and then we can talk about what we're doing and how to wire in the boost control solenoids. All of this information is super critical to making the boost control work properly. If we don't have something configured with our wiring or with the vacuum routing to the boost solenoid and to the wastegate, we'll find that we can never program the boost control properly. We need to make sure the basic fundamental things are taken care of. So let's jump into that right now. So what we're going to be finding on any turbocharged engine, we're going to have an exhaust manifold. The exhaust manifold is going to be funneling out the exhaust gas out of our engine. Now, the exhaust manifold is going to be tied into our turbocharger, specifically onto our turbine housing. Now, in the turbine housing, it's going to hold the turbine wheel. The turbine wheel is going to be spinning as we have more flow and pressure come out of the engine as it's running. And the turbine wheel is going to be linked on a common shaft to our compressor wheel. The compressor wheel is going to be housed in a compressor cover, and that's where we start to generate the flow and the pressure that are going to be pushing into our engine when we're running a turbocharger. So the faster we spin our turbine wheel, the faster we spin our compressor wheel. As that shaft speed picks up, so the shaft speed is going to be the common linked shaft between the turbine wheel and the compressor wheel. So as the shaft speed picks up, the compressor is spun faster, it's going to generate more flow, it's going to generate more pressure, and we'll find that it's going to be feeding that into the engine. So the faster we spin our turbine wheel, the more power production we'll make and the more boost pressure we'll make. Now we need to regulate how quickly that turbine wheel is spinning, or else we're going to be building whatever the boost the turbocharger is able to generate is going to be. So if we didn't have a wastegate assembly and we were just running our turbocharger through the exhaust manifold, pushing the exhaust gas into the turbine housing, spinning the turbine wheel, we might generate 30, 40, 50 pounds of boost pressure. That could damage our engine. It's also going to potentially make too much power for getting traction. So we need to limit the amount of boost pressure we're going to allow our engine to see. That's going to be done through the exhaust housing, and it's going to be controlling how much flow is going through the turbine wheel. That's where a wastegate comes into place. So
thanks for checking out our teaser clip. If you want to see the rest of this video and more than 500 hours of current EFI training we have to offer, make sure you click right here. If you want to go and check out more teaser clips from this training course, click here. And you don't want to miss any of the videos we're going to be releasing on this channel, so make sure you subscribe and click here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.